What's up, guys? This is Rob. You're, of course, on Rule of Two Review. And today, the Xbox One is getting a price cut out of nowhere. I couldn't believe it when I was just making my way home from out and about running errands and whatnot. And all of a sudden, I hear that the Xbox One is going to get a price cut on November 2nd. That's just a couple of weeks' time. It's a few days after Sunset Overdrive comes out. So it's really, really surprising. It's a really bold move. I have to say that, I mean, obviously I like it, because whenever a system is going to be sold for less money, that's exciting for all the people who maybe weren't quite sure if they were interested in that system, maybe on the fence about it. A lot of times when it comes to new generation hardware, people will say, oh, you know, there's a lot of games and stuff I want that's on it, but I'm going to wait for a price drop. People say that stuff a lot. You know, I've said that before as well. I have been waiting for an Xbox One. I wanted one at launch, but I have been waiting to get one, not so much for a price cut, just for when I knew that there were games that I was going to want to play on it. I've talked about this a few times recently. I, of course, had a Wii U from launch day. PlayStation 4, I knew I also wanted when there were going to be games available. And then once I saw the Destiny bundle for PlayStation 4, I was like, okay, well, I'll get my PlayStation 4 next with the Destiny bundle. And then I will, excuse me, then I will continue to wait until the Xbox One has really good games to play. And then I'll pick up an Xbox One. And a couple of weeks ago, I actually reserved the white Sunset Overdrive Xbox One bundle, which was only going for $3.99, basically a free copy of Sunset Overdrive, a game that I'm dying to play, amongst many other Xbox One games that I'm dying to play. There's so much to play on the Xbox One right now, or at least coming up really, really soon. Excuse me, I've been a little bit sick, guys, so sorry, forgive my voice. But yeah, there's so many games coming up soon for the Xbox One. I think it has a better library than the PlayStation 4 does. The Wii U obviously has the best library, I think, at least. Xbox One has a really solid library behind that, you know. So I've been so excited to pick up my bundle in a couple days now. A couple days. That's tomorrow, actually. I was going to pick up my bundle. But now there's a price drop for $349. And so I'm going to wait. I'm not going to pick up my Xbox One tomorrow, because it's crazy to pay $400 when I could pay $350 in just a week's time. So really quickly, my thoughts on why they're doing this is that it's pretty obvious. They want to be aggressive for the holidays. They've all but come out and said that. The PlayStation 4 has been doing fantastically. The Wii has been picking up a lot of steam. The Xbox One has also been picking up steam, but it's in third place. So I feel like Microsoft and, you know, probably Phil Spencer know that they're in third place. And considering they've been in like a neck-and-neck race with the PlayStation 4, because they came out at the exact same time, when you compare those two systems directly, the PlayStation 4 has done way better than the Xbox One. Which is too bad, because I think the Xbox One has still done okay, but the difference is that it's compared to the same one-year lifespan of the PlayStation 4, which has done so much more. So here they are in third place. I think a really solid system. They finally turned a lot of the early mistakes around. They've got so many games. I'm so excited for like the Master Chief Collection, and for Scalebound next year, and for Sunset Overdrive right now. There's just so much to do. I can't wait to pick up Titanfall, Killer Instinct. There was another one too. There's just a lot of really good exclusive content, you know. I feel like for my multiplat stuff, I'll end up playing that, since most of that doesn't come to the Wii U, which is where I would prefer to play it. I'd probably end up playing the multiplat stuff on the PlayStation 4, because there's really not a lot of games on the PlayStation 4. So like Call of Duty, Dragon Age, The Evil Within that I've been going through, that's all PS4 stuff. Nintendo, the Wii U, I get all my Nintendo games, and for the Xbox One, I'll get the other exclusive that they have, Master Chief, Sunset Overdrive, and stuff like that. So I think that this price drop is going to help, and it's really going to be interesting to see if maybe Sony will follow suit at some point. I mean, that's who knows. It's going to start to become a more heated race as this goes along, and coming right into the holidays for 2014, I think that these are the right kind of bold, aggressive moves. They've dropped the price twice now. I think the first one when they dropped the Kinect was, gosh, what was that, March or May, maybe, or April? I mean, it was like spring, like early in the year, I'm pretty sure. Right before E3. So that's a big deal to do it twice in 1 year, man. But right before E3, they got a $100 price drop and removed the Kinect. And then here we are just a couple weeks before Black Friday, a month basically, and they've dropped it another $50. So that's an amazing price. That's a great deal for an Xbox One. And I say that as somebody who's not an Xbox One owner now, but man, that's a really damn good deal. So you've got the Wii U at $299, $300 basically. You've got the Xbox One at $350 and the PlayStation 4 at $400, you know? So the real question becomes, will Sony do the same thing? Will they drop the price soon? I feel like no, they won't. I'll wrap this video up here, really quick video. I don't think that they're going to drop the price soon. I feel like they don't have to because they're still selling so well. It'll be really interesting to see if the momentum changes after the holiday. I think it will. I love my PlayStation 4. Even without a lot of games, I like the system, and I can't wait for the exclusives down the road in like a year's time. So I think that through this holiday, the Xbox One and the Wii U's library is going to trounce the PlayStation 4's. And although the PS4 is certainly a good piece of hardware, without games, people are going to start to realize that they don't give a shit, and I really don't know. So I'm going to be playing Dragon Age and Call of Duty also on the PlayStation 4 before the end of the year. So literally every single game I will have, which is Destiny, Shadow of Mordor, The Evil Within, and Dragon Age and Call of Duty, every single one is a multi-platform game that I could play on another system if I wanted to. And so those are good games, but they're just not exclusive. So I think that with the Xbox One, with the price cut, and its, you know, library starting to get much stronger even before the end of the year, and the Wii U's already got a really good library. I mean, I just feel like sometime after the year, maybe around the same time that the Xbox One had to drop the price earlier this year, so March, April, May time in 2015, that's when I could see Sony doing a price drop. Mark my words, it's going to happen. And they should. At that point, you know, a year and a half or so, it's time to drop the price. $350, I think, is a completely legitimate price to ask for the PS4. I mean, $400 is too, don't get me wrong, but at that point, if the tides really start to turn the way I think that they may, Sony's going to have to do that. And it'll help them big time. I think that that'll gain a lot of the sales that they may potentially lose if this stuff holds true. So, I don't know. Anyway, that's it. Those are my really super quick thoughts. I cannot think or speak straight for days, you guys. I'm so sorry. I'm not in the best shape to be making videos, but I don't want to not make videos, so I'm just doing what I can. But yeah, like I said, I was running out and about, and when I found this out, this was so crazy. I just got home, so I was like, I gotta really quickly touch base and just kind of share some of my quick immediate thoughts about this. It's really exciting. I hope that this works for Microsoft. I hope that it sells more systems. I can't wait to get mine. I was really excited to pick it up tomorrow, but it's gonna be worth another week to wait. I'm still playing through Bayonetta 2, and then I want to go back to The Evil Within, you know, and so I've got enough to play that I can definitely be kept busy until I get Sunset Overdrive and my brand new, spanking new Xbox One in a week, so I can't wait. I'll have all three current-gen consoles come that time, so anyway, those are my thoughts on the Xbox One price drop and a little bit of my predictions for where all three systems might be going in the near future. What is it you guys think? Of course, share your thoughts. Do you think this is a bold, smart move for Microsoft? Or do you think that this is dumb and too soon and it's going to hurt them long term? Where do you think Sony will end up in the price drop war? And yeah, I don't know. Share your guys' thoughts. Of course, thanks for tuning into my quick vlog format kind of video today. Subscribe to Rule 2 Review, like and share the video, all that good old stuff. And I will, of course, catch you guys on the next video.